Hello everyone, this is Anshika Jain working as a legal intern for the Lexis & Law company for the month of July. I hope all of you are amazing and doing great. So today let's discuss a very important topic, the topic that is what is inevitable accident, and let's discuss and analyze it with the help of various cases to get more the gist regarding this topic. So unforeseen injury that could have been averted even with the defendant's reasonable care might be described as an inevitable accident. An inevitable accident is one that cannot be prevented by any wise individual even after taking all the reasonable precautions. It can be a good defense under the law of tort. Inevitable accident can also be used as a defense if the defendant can prove that he or she had no intention of injuring the plaintiff. Despite their best efforts, they were unable to avoid the accident. In order for an accident to be unavoidable, the following elements must be present. That is, first, the mishap should have been unexpected, the occurrence was beyond the defendant's control, and the defendant had no way of avoiding it, and reasonable caution and attention should also be exercised. Now let's see a very important judgment, that is Holmes versus Mather. In this case, horse of defendant, they was driven on a roadway by a servant. The defendant's horses were frightened enough by a dog's bark that they lost the control of themselves. So the defendant horse, he harmed the plaintiff despite the best efforts and of servants to manage the horses. In this case, it was held that the defendant was not responsible since the accident was unavoidable and beyond the defendant's control, despite the fact that the defendant servant attempted to control it in it every possible way. Now let's see another important judgment, that was of Assam State Corporation etc. and the Federation Limited versus Anubhava Sinha. In this case, the premises the plaintiff was given on a rent of a defendant. The defendant, who was a tenant, he requested the plaintiff to repair the electric wiring which was defective, but the plaintiff did not pay the attention and to his request, and there occurred a fire on the premises of the defendant which was accidental. And it was found that there was no negligence on the part of the defendant. Afterward, the plaintiff claimed compensation from the defendant, but the court held that it was a mishap which cannot be prevented. The defendant cannot be held liable since it was an inevitable accident. Another important judgment was Fire and General Insurance Company versus Raj Rani. This was a case of negligence rather than inevitable accident, but in the case, the front right spring and the patta of the truck broke down all of a sudden, and the vehicle lost its control and slammed into a tractor approaching from the opposite way. The truck driver and the owner, they were unable to demonstrate in the court that the truck was in a proper working order and they had all reasonable precautions while driving it. So there was also a mechanical problem in this truck while driving. And also, as a result, it was held that it was a case of a careless rather than unavoidable accident, and the defendant in this case was found responsible. So we can conclude that inevitable accident, it is an unavoidable and is a viable defense if a person can show that the accident could not have been avoided even with the defendant's due attention and the care. So in the accident, and also inevitable accident means an unexpected injury which could not have been foreseen and avoided by the defendant. So I hope all of you have understood what actually is inevitable accident. Please feel free to ask any question in the comment section. Thank you very much, and always keep smiling.